Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Tuesday, July 17. We're coming to you live inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team has been monitoring the systems aboard the station and supporting the day's activities of the Expedition 32 crew members. Leading the Orbit 2 team here in the Station Flight Control Room today is Flight Director Ron Spencer. Next to him is Josh Matthew, there in the red shirt, who is serving as CAPCOM. He's been relaying all ground messages up to the crew. Aboard the orbiting complex, Station Commander CENNADY Padalka and Flight Engineer Sergey Revin and Joe Acaba, who are in their 10th week in space, welcomed three new crew members aboard their orbital home early this morning. Russian cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko, NASA astronaut Sunny Williams, and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide aboard their Soyuz 05M spacecraft docked to the space station after their successful launch from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan this past Saturday night. After a two-day chase on orbit, the Soyuz spacecraft docked to the Rosviat module of the space station last night at 11:51 p.m. Central Time as the two vehicles were flying over northeast Kazakhstan. Padalka, Revin, and Acaba began their long day with a wake-up at 7 p.m. Central Time last night to support the arrival of their new crew members who joined them aboard the International Space Station. After a series of leak and pressure checks and the hatches between both vehicles were opened early this morning at 2:23 Central Time. The new trio joined the crew for a greeting ceremony and conference with family and mission officials, then conducted a safety briefing afterward. It is now back to business for the current station residents while their newly arrived crewmates begin several days of familiarization tasks as they adjust to life aboard the orbital laboratory. Awaiting their new crewmates to join them aboard the International Space Station, Commander Padalka, Revin, and Acaba had launched to the orbiting complex aboard their Soyuz spacecraft as the Expedition 31 crew back in May. Their vehicle docked to the Poisk module of the space station 2 days after their launch on May 14, and today the trio will complete their 65th consecutive day in space. Padalka, Revin, and Acaba had adjusted their sleep shift with that earlier bedtime yesterday for an earlier wake-up at 7 p.m. last night to accommodate the successful docking that occurred at 11:51 p.m. Central Time. The space station with all six crew members aboard and the Soyuz TMA-05M, now docked, is flying at an altitude of about 254 statute miles. The orbiting facility is on a night pass on a northeastern track, just coming across Australia on the east coast of Australia, and will soon make its way across the North Pacific Ocean. Padalka, Revin, and Acaba, having adjusted their sleep shift with a wake-up last night, began their active long day with the first of two daily planning conferences a couple hours after wake-up. These planning conferences are held with ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. The task at the top of the list today being the arrival of their new crew members. Revin and Acaba had spent the earlier part of their day with maintenance tasks. Acaba performed air quality monitoring and maintenance to the onboard water recovery system, while Revin performed maintenance to the Russian life support system, known as SOJ. Meanwhile, Commander Padalka spent last night focused on preparation for docking and monitoring Soyuz rendezvous to the space station. This Soyuz again docked to the station at 11:51 p.m. Central Time last night as the two vehicles flew across northeast Kazakhstan. While awaiting their new crew members to join them aboard the station, Padalka and Revin turned their attention to data collection and maintenance to a few ongoing Russian science experiments. Once the hatches were opened between the newly arrived Soyuz and the station at 2:23 a.m. Central Time, Malenchenko, Williams, and Hoshide joined their crewmates aboard the orbiting facility, making up the full complement of the Expedition 32 crew. Newest residents of the space station spent some time this morning setting up their crew quarters and bringing items aboard the station that were brought up with them aboard their Soyuz spacecraft. Aki and Sunny both participated in their first private medical conference, while Akaba performed nitrogen pressure checks to the onboard minus 80-degree laboratory freezer. This is the onboard refrigeration system for storing biological and experiment samples for later return to Earth. The six-member expedition crew is now settling down in their pre-sleep period aboard the space station as they prepare for a well-deserved sleep that will put them back to the normal station operations clock for their first full day of work together as a full crew aboard the orbiting complex tomorrow. The crew is scheduled to go to bed just at the bottom of the hour at 11 a.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.